The Simpsons. We know they are fun. We know they're energetic.
So your hair might not look that new for the next.
Listen. You see how you met me, how you look for the wedding video? You can't do that to me again, you know.
Why
your
not?
Name husband, so I represent you. So you have to ensure that the person.
So then you have to look as crazy and wacky as I am.
No, you want somebody that looks nice on your arm.
And now we know their first kiss experience was quite unusual.
First kiss as husband and wife, you mean first kiss full stop?
That was the first kiss full stop, by the way.
It was the first kiss.
Yeah. And his first kiss ever.
Thank you for sharing that with the world.
I love you.
Joanna. It was first kiss. Yeah, I mean, you know, like when you see them on TV and them kiss and them do them thing. Something like that. But you don't know, say. Oh, we would have to star it up a little. Yeah.
You're not saying anything.
What I'm
are
not.
You saying? No.
Of course I'm saying a lot.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that our kiss was different because it was me and you and, you know, I don't know. It just... You know, like when you see them...
No, okay, so was it, all right, good? You know, was it bad? Was it in between? Did you think, okay, this needs some tweaking, like...
Was it good as in comparison to what? You just bust bubble and said the first time. As in comparison
no, but you
to what?
You don't have to be in comparison to. You just.
Did I like it?
Yo, if you eat a lollipop, you can say, I like this lollipop or I don't like this lollipop.
Okay, I like this lollipop.
So, what was the rationale behind not kissing before the wedding day?
The truth of the matter is, alright, Joanna had a strong resolve about kissing. And what if we just be real?
It wasn't just a kiss, you know, but it was just how we interacted with each other, you know. From previous experiences, I realized that our state is, right? I know, say, the Bible talks about it's flee sexual immorality and...
Flee youthful lust.
Flee youthful lust, right? And so I know that when it reached a certain point, I want to kiss. But you see, when you kiss enough, in my experience and my opinion, right, it doesn't always stay there, you know, you explore, right, and so it moves on. And so I didn't want to get to that point because I know that if I kiss and we explore, I'm going to feel bad and then I'm going to have to repent, right, but then I'm going to want it more and so it's just going to be difficult.
Yeah.
And so I made a decision, right, that he eventually respected. It wasn't really his opinion, but you know, even from the beginning, before we got into a relationship, some of the decisions I've made, he's like, I don't necessarily take it as my own. I don't really believe that this is what the Lord is saying to me. But because this is your decision, I respect it.
It's something that, you had to respect because in knowing that, listen, if this is going to lead to somewhere where you don't want to go, I mean, don't play with fire. Don't play with fire. It's better just leave it and wait.
That's Joanna and Damoi's experience. Let's hear from our counselors for another premarital issue.
A man who feels that he wants to get married and the lady is not ready, he needs to use the time that he has to get himself in a position where he can be even more prepared for her when she is ready. For if he forces her and she goes the way he wants, then she's only going to be a slave and she's going to feel like she is being used. He needs to be patient. He needs to be understanding. And if he's a mature individual who understands that male and female will have different needs and have different goals, he will be able to apply patience and wait. And real love is not just how you feel. Real love is about putting yourself in another person's place, understanding what is it that motivates a person, what is a person's goals and dreams. A man who forces a woman to do exactly what he wants, we'll find out that life will not be something that he will get the most out of. For she will always be holding back. a wife, an individual, a woman who understands that he has a man who will trust her, who will be patient with her, who will give her an opportunity to come at the pace that she's able to handle, then he'll be a better husband.
Ladies, from about the age of 4 or 5, we start to think about being the mommy, being the wife, and eventually that wonderful, magical, princess-filled wedding day. Unfortunately, the husbands or the future husbands do not have that same point of view, and they feel that things need to be a certain way before they commit to taking on the responsibilities of being a husband. I know it can get frustrating when we see our friends getting married around us and always the bridesmaid and never the bride, but you have to understand that what's okay for someone else is not always okay for you. Never rush yourself into a marriage just because you're feeling a little jealous, and then 2 months down the road after being married, you've realized it's not really what it was cracked up to be. It wasn't meeting your expectations. As a way of helping yourself to deal with the frustration of waiting, first of all, you need to ask yourself, why is my future husband or why is my boyfriend waiting? Is it because of financial reasons? Is he not ready financially to take on the responsibilities of being a husband? Secondly, you want to think about what are his past experiences? What are the emotions behind him waiting? What is he trying to sort out within himself? And you have to allow him that time to work through these things. I think if we understand why they're holding back, we're then able to deal with, I can wait another year or two, or I can wait a couple months.
Joanna and Damoi tell us about their marriage experience.
We've been married for about
2 weeks and 1 day. It has been great, actually. It has been great. Being newlyweds, it is all that it has cracked up to be, all the rumors that you hear about newlywed life. It is true. It is wonderful, trust me. Right now we're still in glory land, you know.
And hopefully we stay there.
You know. We will stay there in the name of Jesus.
My parents have had many years of glory land. It's been good. It's been good. A little bit of a challenge though, because what marriage has meant for me is really a moving from my life, you know, as I know it, and moving into his, and you know, kind of owning our life together and owning what his life, and you know, kind of infusing myself in it. And so it has been a challenge, but it's been good. I have a very fun husband, so he keeps me very entertained, you know, so it's good. But there have been challenges.
I have a good audience. So.
Yeah, there's always laughter.
In all the laughter and fun, the Simpsons shared on aspects of marriage that were challenging during their first few weeks of marriage.
Homesickness. A little bit, and then I look at her, and then no.
Oh, that's sweet. I have certainly, you know, a lot of homesickness. I call it homesickness, short sickness, everything sickness. I've experienced it. After we came back from our honeymoon, I came home and I just saw my mom and I just bawl, you know? And I was just like, I can't believe this. You know, you talk about marriage and you're gonna get married and this and that, and you're like, oh, I'm gonna go off with my love. And then you get married and you realize, oh my gosh, I have to leave my family. And so the day we came back, it really hit me. You know, and just being at his church last week for the first time, as now I'm going to the church, this is my church, this is our church, it was a challenge.
Joanna is a late person. I'm a late bird, I'm an early bird. So when I flip on the switch on her in the morning, I become instantly her enemy. And it's like, ah, why? You know, but, you know, it's been getting used to, you know, because I have to stay up late sometimes because, facilitate the talking, spending time with her, let her know how my day went, all of that. So the late bird versus the early bird, is a bit rocky, but we are developing a routine.
So housework is
don't tell
really.
Me you have a different perspective. After I gave that wonderful rendition, yeah, you have a different.
It sounds good. It sounds good, and you know, somewhere deep down in my heart, you know, I agree. But housework, I'm trying to become friends with it. You know, we weren't really friends before. We were enemies. But you know, I know that as a man, you know, I've come to realize, you know, with friends and stuff, men like to see their house clean, right? And also, he likes to be served, you know? So he had this big thing about setting up the house. So he wanted to set up the house for his wife. And I mean, we didn't get all the things that we needed at the outset or before we got married. In fact, we found the place like a week before, right? But, you know, so when we came in, he made a point of duty to ensure that he was the one doing most of the things so that he could set up the house. So anytime I went out, I would come back and I'd see TV set up and music equipment set up or curtain set up and, you know, stuff like that. But I realized also that because he was also very used to doing it before and has no problem doing it, that he, you know, would just do it and I could sit back. So I've been trying to, you know,
you've been doing a good job of it.
You know, ensure. And no, wait. I try to ensure that I also do work. So I ensure that I do the kitchen and that I'm always serving him so that whenever he is, he's doing work, you know, housework and whatever, he has stuff. And then I actually conquered the toilet, which was something that I said I wouldn't do and he would have to do. But you know, when things are necessary, right, you just, you have to do it.
Before leaving, Damoi shared his idea of a happy marriage.
I don't believe that just loving someone guarantees a happy marriage. It takes more than that. I mean, first of all, it takes God, right? Love is God, right? So that being said, we have to know what, there are different components of love, right? One is spending time, and I don't know if you know about the five love languages, but the five love languages, you know, you have to know your partner and getting to know her, know what she likes, and in knowing what she likes, you know, do those things, right? Also, there are some things that are required of us. It's not necessarily easy, right? But there are sacrifices, and these sacrifices are what are the basis.
We followed up with the Simpsons since this interview. They are now married for 3 months, and Joanna has become better friends with housework. One thing has remained the same, though, their commitment to each other. Visit our Facebook page for the chance to win amazing prizes.